Hi there and welcome to Stellaris Utopia and the culture. And we're winning a war, unfortunately not versus these guys. This is the Brethren Scourge, preying on Gur, the Domana Dominion, and we don't really know yet if we can stand with them, but against them, but we find them interesting, as I can shortly show you. We can communicate. This is clearly an important species we're dealing with. Yuzugamak Vatar Ragator Hak Hak. That's what they say. And that's what they do. And that's what they... Oh, that's the Brethren Scourge. I remember these times when I always said, this is the culture, this is the culture, this is the culture, and this is the culture. Now the same goes now for the Brethren Scourge. They are expanding everywhere, and our only way to like stop them is lead this war against the Xolpi Empire, which will soon now finish, because we wanted to move in against the Brethren when they were like, ah, this is the Brethren Scourge. And what happened then? Well, the Xolpi Empire just insulted us and like threatened with a war declaration, basically. So if we had attacked and stopped the Brethren, we would have been eliminated by the Xolpi Empire. Yay! So we had to do this first. But while doing this first, the Brethren took apart like everything here. So what we're doing now is we're beating down the Xolpi Empire so they cannot threaten us anymore. And we have built a lot of... or we have constructed a lot of anti-Prethorin ships. Now how do you do anti-Prethorin ships? They need to have very good weapons against armor. And you also need to have pointy defense against their swarmling missiles and basically little cruisers. No, not cruisers. These little flyers, these little hangar-based things. So we're going everywhere with a large plasma-based cannons that ignore 90% of armor, from which they have like 80%, 90%. So let's hope this goes well. And yeah. To boot, we should really go and actually go for the tachyon lens here on our Prethorin, anti-Prethorin XL, because it's better, yeah, you guessed it, against armor. Giga cannon wasn't bad, but now we're going that way. So, but now, the war is coming to a close. Here on Gekoler, we will attack and decide the war. Now. Decide it. Come on. Napoleon Ghetto. We gave you that... Oh, wait. We have an incoming transmission from the artists. Here follows the latest newsletter for all our patrons. The Enclave is in a frisky mood. The creation of the Centaurus Rift has caused many an artist to change their primary focus to creating new experiences for it. So far the most noteworthy to come out of this endeavor is an orchestral piece conveyed via scent. Our work continues and any donations would be gladly accepted. Well, we would like to donate, because we love to donate to you. We joyously accept your donation and promise that it will be used in the most creative of endeavors. It's giving you, like, influence like there's no tomorrow, so we love these guys. And one of our fleets is in combat. Yeah, we have found another fleet here. Ha, huh, in the Triumph system. That is where they will lose another fleet. Right. And there is some kind of armada here, but to be honest, we don't care. We'll fly back then. Once this planet is taken, we should have enough to actually finish the war with all that we want. And then we'll see if we can keep it. And how this works with a new system. So there we go. Nearly a full win. We want everything, and we get it. Because of our relative navy strength, and like everything else, we'll win this war. Have you accepted, Solpies? Yes, you have. A new faction has recently been gaining traction in the internal political landscape of the culture by scientist AI Zwester and M4L. They call themselves the Neutrality Movement. Their members are advocating for closed borders and non-interference with galactic affairs. So we have xenophobes now. Yay! Oh my god, the Neutrality Movement. National solvency will hopefully come back to okay. Now we have finished the war. The authoritarian coalition. We have to propagate our stuff more. And thankfully, we have won this war with the following demands. Seed planet. And now we have a lot to organize. Like, this is the new political landscape we have added. Tiffim. Hadriga's Bastion. There's a lot of Solpies. Partly happy because we freed them from slavery. Partly very unhappy because, well, recently conquered. So we have a great mix. Look at this one. He's an egalitarian Solpy. He's very happy. Saved from slavery too. So this is a deeply divided thing. And now the first thing we need to do here is build spaceports. With probably projectile defense, because that's our thing. So Hadriga's Bastion, build that. If that Almak, then Orglion. Thankfully, they've also built a lot of stations here already, so we're in good spirits for, like, anything. That they're so divided is also a chance for us, by the way. And why are we building spaceports now? Like, there's no tomorrow. It is basically because we have like something nice for the spaceports that will smoothen their transition to the culture. We can show it to you here. The orbital mind control laser. Governing ethics attraction plus 50%. That's what will be constructed very soon on this. But now first, I mean, oh, look at that. Unrest. Ooh. We need a good governor for these planets, and we'll also make it we may add it to the educating the brood sector. That may be really a good idea. So we're saving for another sector. Or we're saving us creating another sector. Maybe let's go for, I don't know, this system. And then we can go here and add these planets. Why can't we add this? Well, because we don't have Yod-Bem. Right, but we have Tiffim. How can we come here to Orglion? I think we can only go there through that system or that system. Let's go through that system and then Orglion. Oh, and from here we also come to Caspedin, to Landis, and to Althine. Well done. This is the new Educating the Brutes sector. It's a big sector now. Do we have a good governor for this sector? That squashes unrest. I think we should, right? Educating the Brutes sector? Yes. Unit V13 should be quite experienced enough. He has an agrarian upbringing. He's a synthetic, so people love him. And look at our leaders tab, V13. Unrest minus 25. No, that's pretty great. Mr. Governor, sir. Shouldn't have much problems with unrest now anymore. Well, there's still enough Obon in the Landis system. There's a spaceport being built, yes. Now we need to send over, as long as this is still going, science ships. Where do we have good time? There's still something in Barnard's Star? I suppose not. Oh, there is debris in Barnard's Star. That is not bad. We'll send a few ships out. You can go there. Oh, we cannot go to Barnard's Star, right? Or can we? Seems like we can. We'll try that out. And then we have him. He still needs experience. We have Dusabal, the genius. He should try to make sense out of, like, everything. This guy. We want to send the really... Yeah, maybe you. You're a substance abuser. No. Don't have 5 stars. Need these 5 stars, guys, on it. Caspedin. And on barely warming. It's here. Away stain. Maybe here in the Lessim system. Sirius. Bleak Star. Now let's bring the transport fleets, all the other fleets, let's bring them back. Back to home. Back to home. To the Swebi Embassy, in that case, to the other rim world. So now the new center, and we might really move our capital, maybe. I don't know. Will we? Yeah, we have won the war. Rightfully so. Very well, citizen. Let us end this war in the spirit of reconciliation. That's what you need now. And what we need now is... We need so many ships. Of course, we're coming back to this. The Prethorin Scourge is what threatens us all. It's like climate change. You ignore it, it's tiny, and you think, oh man. Not so much snow this year. Well, that's okay. don't have to shovel it out of my garage entry, whatever. Oh, migration treaty ending that. Ooh. The universe doesn't love us anymore. It could be. It could be. And why? Because we're a threat now. We're conceived as a threat, as a big threat. Yeah. Let this be told. You're conceived as a threat once you declare war on someone. Before you can be as powerful as you want, you won't be a threat, apparently. But really, have you really taken the Xolpi Empire down? I doubt it. It's still that big and appalling blob out there. Well, there's new things we can do. We want to build an observation post here. And also, basically, we want to build some mining stations. And don't know. Build some mining stations here. Or rather, research stations here, and then mining stations here. All shall be done in time. Oh, we cannot build mining stations here. But we can move there. Can we then build a mining... We cannot afford. What? Because this planet is not within our... Oh, yes, it is not within our borders, it seems. Alright, this one, Morton World Nation. This one, our space. Move here. And we are lacking... What? I don't know what goes on here, but... Some strange things are working out. Let's see about the sectors. How are the sectors doing? Educating the Broods is doing well. Oh, we can tax them a bit. Just a bit. They don't need that many energy credits anymore. And we can get them in turn. That is good news. Also, maybe the curators want to help us again. Very nice. And... Commerce exchange. Interested in strategic resources. We want to buy your spice. 1,000? That's basically very, very cheap. You will not be sorry. Unless you consume too much spice, of course. And there's a small chance you will spontaneously combust. A very small chance, to be sure. Well, that's nothing for now. Goodbye. We've bought everything we could. We'll see that we continue our great ways. Oh, and we'll of course start some mind control lasers soon, hopefully. When will this be finished? 9 months. Alright, that's great. Anti-pretherian energy. Oh yeah. Finished everything. All is well. So, we're getting repaired. Unrest. Radicalization! The unrest on Nephobon has led to mounting calls from the locals for a more pronounced military presence in their home planet and within the culture as a whole. My god! Was that here? Nephobon. Need some defense armies of the Aphron. Yes, they are stronger. Build even more. The militarist ethics. We need to suppress them now. I mean, the culture is free and all, but this is clearly an influence of the newly misguided people. These guys, probably. Huh. Oh, they are xenophobes. All right. The patriotic vanguard. They are happy now. Scientist Unit Alpha. Yeah, well. We'll see how this goes. Our militarists are growing. And, I mean, we can suppress the smaller factions. We don't really want xenophobes here. This will displease them and any like-minded factions and make their ethics less attractive to a population as long as it is active. Wow. Minus one influence, is that true? Yes, it is true. Stop it again. No, we'll do this with our glorious buildings and glorious policies, not with brute force. What can we do there? Information quarantine. That's the first thing we'll do. It's cheaper than suppressing these little ones. Next thing is we'll add some of these new lasers that I hear are so nice to look at. Oh, we apologize, Patron Unit M1D. We have sadly reached something of a creative roadblock. Enclave is in disarray, and we have nothing to offer at this time. Thank you for your patronage, as always. Demand a refund? No. We hope the situation improves. We humbly thank you for your kind words, and we'll send them along to the rest of the troop. And let's actually look at the far away things here. It seems like they are really in line with what we need, what we want, but nevertheless, these lasers, I hear they are great to unite our people against the enemy. Between the Fallen, the Archivist Embassy, yeah, we're building some upgrades here. Prime C2. Warm Love System. The Alps. The Resistance to the Barbarians. Erdoska System. At least on the planets, we want to have these things going well. The orbitals, though, they are uncontrollable, really. So we must do what we can with policies. Now we must reunite the galaxy under the cultural banner. Nafobon. Yes, can we do something there, by the way? Re-education campaigns would probably be really good. And propaganda broadcasts makes them more happy. Should be good too, right? We'll do both. Should be good in time. Cannot afford unrest in our empire. Ah, in the glorious culture. While we prepare for the big fight against the Pretherin, energy weapon damage goes up. Perfecting the firing cannons of laser weaponry is a task that could keep the engineering elite of any given planet busy for centuries. Well then, how about continuing with the attack speed? Should be good too, right? Against the Pretherin. That's what we'll do now. Oh look, we're gaining a lot of force. We should really unite these fleets under one banner. Anti-Pretherin fleets too. We have trade deal offers. Oh. The Ktik Empire offers an active sensor link. We would be very interested in that. The Scientific Directorate offers us Telda crystals and energy credits. Yes, why not? We love you too, Scientific Directorate. They are listening, it seems. Now, Hanajdam Trade Syndicate. They're still cordial with us. But they don't really like us. How is our relative power now? It is still okay. The Thunderland Senate still loves us, but we're perceived as a threat. We hope that will go away in time. But we don't know. I'm a citizen. I would clearly like, dearly like to visit Mother Earth someday. Yeah, you're invited to do so. In fact, I think you come from us, Mr. Affront. Well, now we're a galactic threat. So we should be a threat to the Pretherin as well, right? Does it work that way? Of course, it's a psychological war. That is what we think is most important in this. And to buffer that, we have the anti-Pretherin units. So thank you for watching. We'll try to make something that gets rid of the Pretherin. We'll just need some time. Happy gaming to you. The culture loves you. See you in the next episode.